Hi guys, I hope you all are doing well and welcome to the second video of this entire series. If you have watched the last video, in the last session we discussed what is Azure AD Connect and what are the features or benefits of using Azure AD Connect tool. In this particular video, I will be discussing the architectural view of Azure AD Connect. I will be discussing what is Sync Engine, what are the components of Sync Engine, and how each component works. Azure AD Connect tool has an important component which helps it to work. You can say this component is the heart of Azure AD Connect. This component is called Azure AD Connect Sync or Sync Engine. Sync Engine has four components: connected data source or connected directories, connectors, connector space, and metaverse. These four components help Sync Engine to perform all the activities. If you are synchronizing an object from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory, or if passwords are getting synced from Azure Active Directory to on-premise, all these activities are performed by these four components. Now let's understand how each component works and how these components help Azure AD Connect tool to sync information from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory. In Azure AD Connect, connected data source can be any data repository that organizes data in a database. For example, Active Directory or SQL Server or SQL Server. In a standard Azure AD Connect configuration, connected data sources are Active Directory and Azure Active Directory. If you are using SQL Server in your on-premise environment, then you can use SQL Server database as a connected data source in Azure AD Connect. So in nutshell, connected data source or connected directories are a storage space where your objects are stored. For example, Active Directory, Azure Active Directory, or SQL Server. The second component of Sync Engine is connectors. Each connected data source has a dedicated connector. Connectors are a medium through which data flows from connected data sources to connector space or from connector space to another connected data sources. At one time, data can flow in one direction only. That means at one time, data can flow either from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory or from Azure Active Directory to on-premise Active Directory. The next component of Sync Engine is connector space. Connector space stores a replica of all the objects that are present within connected data sources. For example, if we have two users in Active Directory, connector space will store these objects and their attributes. So now if we make any changes on these two users within Active Directory, these changes will be updated within connector space as well. If we add another user in Active Directory, during sync cycle, connector space will copy the new object and will store this object and its attributes. So with the help of connector space, Sync Engine evaluates whether the data has already been synchronized or not. The fourth component of Sync Engine is Metaverse. Metaverse is a storage area that provides a global view of both connectors. It shows what changes are picked from Active Directory and what changes are going to be exported to Azure Active Directory. Now let's understand what happens when you run a delta or initial sync cycle. I will be discussing both sync cycles in detail in one of the next sessions. But for now, just understand that delta and initial are the types of sync cycles. With the help of a sync cycle, the changes that are done within Active Directory are synchronized or updated within Azure Active Directory. When we initiate a sync cycle, either from PowerShell or from Sync Manager, the first cycle that Sync Engine runs is import AD or import Active Directory. During this cycle, changes that are done within Active Directory objects are picked by Sync Engine and are sent to connector space through Active Directory connector. For example, if you have created a new user account in Active Directory, so during import cycle, during import Active Directory cycle, that user object will be updated within connector space. The next sync cycle is import Azure Active Directory. During this sync cycle, any changes that are made in Azure Active Directory are updated within connector space that is connected with Azure Active Directory. For example, if you have reset password for a user and you have enabled password write back, then passwords will be synced from Azure Active Directory to on-premise Active Directory. The third sync cycle that Sync Engine runs is synchronization Active Directory. During this cycle, the changes that were done in Active Directory are presented within Metaverse, and these changes are updated within Active Directory connector space. Fourth sync cycle is synchronization AAD or synchronization Azure Active Directory. During this sync cycle, the changes that are going to be exported to Azure Active Directory are presented within Metaverse, and these changes are updated within Azure Active Directory connector space. In from AD and out to AAD are the synchronization rules types. In from AD rules decide which objects and attributes will be picked from Active Directory, and out to AAD rules export the changes to Azure Active Directory as per their conditions. We will be discussing synchronization rules in detail in other session, and things will be more clear. The next sync cycle is export Azure Active Directory or export AAD. During this sync cycle, changes that were presented within Metaverse are exported to Azure Active Directory or Office 365. And the sixth sync cycle is export AD or export Active Directory. During this sync cycle, any changes that were picked during import cycle from Azure Active Directory are exported to on-premise Active Directory. So this is how Azure AD Connect synchronize the changes from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory or from Azure Active Directory to on-premise Active Directory. In the next video, I will be discussing what are the prerequisites for Azure AD Connect that needs to be met in Azure Active Directory, and what are the hardware requirements that need to be met in on-premise Active Directory. So if you have learned something new from this particular video, please write in comments and please subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions related to the topics that I'm posting, feel free to write in comments. I will be more than happy to answer your questions. Thank you, guys. Thank you for your time. Take care.